वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज शफीक अहमद एंड यू आर ऑल वेलकम टू योर फेवरेट यूट्यूब चैनल लेट्स लर्न टुगेदर।
सो अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द क्लास वंस अगेन। आवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ सिविक्स दैट इज पॉल साइंस आल्सो इज फेडरलिज्म एंड दिस चैप्टर इज क्वाइट इंटरेस्टिंग आल्सो because it deals a lot about our country also. We will discuss a lot of the things about our country. And you can see in the photograph over here, images, the state plead for more powers. The state is pleading, asking the central government to give more powers. So that we will learn in this chapter, that is also one of the feature of, you can say, federalism, where the state government has to look for the powers from the central government also. Obviously presented by me, Shafiq Ahmed. So before discussing the beginning of the chapter, we will have to recap of the first chapter of Pol Science also. Let us recap few things from that chapter so that everything is crystal clear in our mind. One of the key changes that was made in the constitution of Belgium, if you remember, they have made several constitution in their constitution. They have made several changes in the constitution of Belgium. And what was the real major reason, or you can say what was their intention to do changes in the constitution, was to reduce the power of central government. They wanted that central government should not have all the type of powers. So they made changes in the constitution to reduce the power of central government and to give these powers to the local government, such as, you know, you may call it as a state government also, regional government, local government, you can say. So what they have done they have made changes in the state, in the central government, in the constitution, so that the central government power may be reduced and that power may be given to the state government or the regional government. That was the major changes that they wanted to do in the constitution, and they have done also in Belgium. We are talking about Belgium. All powers were given to regional or local government and could, but it is written over here that it could be withdrawn by the central government. Yes, but the central government has given power to the state government. Doesn't it mean that the state government can misuse those power also? So if the power will be misused, then the central government can withdraw all the powers of the state government also. That was also there in Belgium. Now, the change that took place in the year 1993 in Belgium was that regional government were given constitutional powers that were no longer dependent on the central government. Now the regional government or the state government, you can say, they were given powers, constitutional powers from the constitution, and because of that only they have made changes in the constitution so that no one can take those powers from them. They were not dependent on the central government, but on the other hand, it was also mentioned that if the power will be misused, then it can be withdrawn by the central government. But if it is not misused, then the constitutional powers, the state government will have the constitutional powers, power from the constitution, which will be no longer dependent on the central government. Belgium shifted from a unitary to a federal form of government. So before having this type of federal form of government, the Belgium was having a unitary type of government where the power was only in the hand of the central government, in unitary type of government. And we have also gone through about Sri Lanka also in the first chapter. So what we have learned there, that Sri Lanka continues, you know, to be like a unitary system where the national government were having all the powers. So what really happens in unitary government, all the powers lies in the hand of the central government or the national government. But in federal type of government, the powers are distributed. So Belgium has changed themselves from unitary to federal, but Sri Lanka continues to be there following the system of unitary government. So that is the thing that we have to recap, and we have recapped these things. Tamil leaders who were fighting for their struggle, they were fighting for their independence also. So Tamil leaders wanted Sri Lanka to become a federal system type of government, not unitary system. So from this discussion, we come to know that there are two types of government over here, unitary as well as federal system. So let us go through one by one. We will have a contrast also. We will compare both the governments also in the later part of the chapter. So let us understand what is meant by federalism, or what its real meaning is there. Let us go through. Federal is a system of government in which the power is divided between central authority and various constituent units of its country. Means in federal government, the power is divided between central as well as the different units of the government, such as you can say the state government are there. In federalism, there are two levels of government. One is the government for the entire country, that is the central government, and that is responsible for few subjects of common national interests. Means power which the national government is having, the central government has, they are subjected to take some few decisions on behalf of the country, which will be of common national interest. Means that will be applied throughout the country. Means the power has been given by the constitution to the central government that they can take decisions. They are responsible for few subjects of the common national interest. That we will also deal in the later part of the chapter, that what are the powers given to this type of government, to central government. So as I told you that there are two levels of government in federalism. One is the central government and the other are governments at the level of provinces, or you can say local level, regional level, or state level, you can say. So the others are the government at the state level that look after much of the day-to-day administrating of their state. The day-to-day activities are administered or controlled by the state government. And that's why federalism has two types of government there, has two level of government, you can say. Number one is the central government, and the other is what? The state government. But let us see. There are a few more things that we should discuss on, that both these levels of government enjoy their power independent of the other. Both the governments, the state government as well as the central government, they enjoy their power independently. I mean, they don't have to answer to each of them. But separately, you can see that they are answerable to the people. That is quite concerned, that if they are not answerable to each other, but they are obviously answerable to the people. Now you can see over here in this map, read out the letter bottom part, that though only 25 of the world's 193 countries have federal political system. You can see over here that only 25 out of 193 countries have this type of government, federal type of government. Their citizens make up 40% of the world population. Means these 25 countries are having huge population over here, that they make up 40% of the world's population. These 25 countries who have the federal type of government, these countries are having huge population. Large countries of the world are having this type of government, federal type of, because it is easy to administer. The central government cannot administer all the states by sitting at a place in New Delhi or in the capital of the country. So it is better to divide the power among themselves. Central and the state level, so that they can take care of the day-to-day activities in their area. Can you notice an exception to this rule in this map? Now you will have to notice what is the exception over here. This red one is showing that these countries are having federal type of government, red one, and a federal political system. Canada, United States of America, even Mexico, Russia, you can see over here, Australia, South Africa, India, and there Germany, Belgium, Switzerland, Spain, all of are having over here, you can see, federal type of government. So what you have to find out over here, that is there any exception to this rule? Is there any exception? So that you will have to pass it in the comment section. What exception you have found, we will deal in the next class about that exception. Okay. Between the unitary as well as the federal type of government, what is the contrast between them? So go through properly. Either there is only one level of government or the subunits, or you can say the assistant. Means there is only one level of government. We are talking about unitary government. In unitary government, there is only one level of government, that is the central government. And now the central government can have its assistant. You can't say that they are dividing the powers. No, they are not dividing the power. Their assistant. They are just giving or creating their assistant, or in other words, you can say subordinate or subunits also. So they are all answerable. They are all answerable to this central government. Means the central government is there in a small form also, in unitary government. So the central government has not divided its power, has not given its power to anyone, but they are creating their units also so that they can control. Suppose there is a head police station, and the head police station is creating some small police stations also in local areas so that they can have a full control. And all the branches of that government or the head police station is having the same power. So no, they are not dividing the powers in unitary government. All the powers lies in the hand of only one government, that is the, you can say, the central government, or only one level of government. The central government can pass on orders to the provincial or the local government. So the central, the head office, and they can pass to their, they can pass orders to the subordinate or to their assistants, and those who are helping them to maintain. So in this unitary government, it is so that they will have to listen to the orders. The assistant will have to listen to the orders of the head office, or you can say the central government. So they are not dividing powers. I'm telling you again. Power have not been divided, just it has been distributed, or subordinates or assistants have been created so that they can maintain throughout the country. About the central federalism, federal type of government. In a federal system, the central government cannot order the state government to do something because they have decided. In the federal system of government, they used to decide among themselves that what will be controlled by which government. Central government will control what and state government will control what. So the central government over here in federal system, they cannot order the state government to do something. State government has powers of its own for which it is not answerable to the central government. Now you can see it is quite clear over here that in unitary type of government, the central government can pass orders to the subordinates or assistant, means their assistant. They can pass orders to the local government which they have created in unitary type of government. But in central government, only the central government, what they can do, they have just created their branches, and those they are state government, but they cannot order the state government to do anything. For the state government will have its own power, and they don't have to answer to the central government. That is the main difference over here, that in unitary system, central government can pass orders to the regional or the local government. In unitary system, central government can pass orders to the local government, and those local government are answerable to the central government as well. They will have to answer whether they have followed the instruction or not. But in federal system, the central government cannot order the state government to do anything, because central state government is having their own power, and they are also not answerable to the central government. That is quite important. They don't have to answer to the central government. But my students, as I told you earlier also, that both these governments separately, they are both answerable to us, to the citizen of the country, or you can say to the people of the country. They are answerable. It doesn't mean that they are not answerable to anyone. Yes, state government is not answerable to the central government, But state government is answerable to the people, means to the citizen of the country, as well as the central government is also answerable to the citizen of the country. They are separately answerable. Separately means dono hi akele akele alag alag jo hai, wo log answerable hai, wo logon ko jawab dena hoga hum logon ko. But it is not obvious that they will answer to each other. So that is the contrast between the unitary and the federal type of government, my dear students. Okay, let us go through to the next part of the chapter, that key features of federalism. So what are the key features? What are the important features? Key means what? Very important. Very important features we are going to discuss. So there are two or more levels of government in federalism. Number one means the in federalism, the levels of government may be two, maybe more than two also. That is the first feature. Next is one, different tiers of government govern the same citizens. Means we are the citizen of India as well as we are the citizen of our state also. So different tiers of government with different levels of government, they are governing the same citizens. Central government is, if central government is passing some order, then it is applicable to each and every citizen of the country. And if the state government is passing some orders to the citizen of the country, then the citizens are also same over here. So the same citizens is having two type of government on them. That is clear over here, that different levels of government are having and governing the same citizens. But each level of government has its own jurisdiction. And a jurisdiction that is a legally authorized area or power. So each level of government has their own jurisdiction or power in specific matters of, they can decide separately on this particular matters, such as legislation, means forming new rules for the country or new act, even taxation as well as administration. With these levels of government, they can take independent decisions on themselves, by themselves, on these three levels, on these three specific matters, which are legislation, taxation and administration. The jurisdiction means the powers of the respective these levels of government, which are subdivided, are specified in the constitution. So the powers are specified fully in the constitution. This is written clearly in the constitution, that what will be the powers of the state government or the different levels of government, what type of powers they will have. So the existence and authority of each type of government is constitutionally guaranteed. So the constitution is giving guarantee to the different levels of government that they will have these powers. These powers cannot be taken by the central government. So the constitution is giving the power. It is clearly mentioned in the constitution what will be the powers of the different levels of government in the country. So they are constitutionally guaranteed. The fundamental provisions or the rules of or instructions, or you can say provisions of the constitution, cannot be unilaterally, that is iktarfa, changed by one level government. Means the central government cannot only change the constitution of the government. They will have to take suggestions as well as approval of the state government. Such changes require the consent. Consent means samati of both the levels of government. If there are two levels of government, then both the level of government should agree to make changes in the constitution of the country. Then only they can make changes in the constitution. And if there are three levels of government, four levels of government in federalism, it may be. So they will have to, you can give consent to make some changes in the constitution, or sahmati dena padega. Sahmati lena padega central government ko, agar constitution mein kuch change karna hai, wo akele nahi kar sakta. Even the state government cannot make changes, the different levels of government cannot make changes in the constitution by only themselves. They will have to take consent from others also. So that is all in this class, my dear students. We have gone through four key features of the federalism. More when we meet again in our next class. That's all. Thank you, my dear students. Bye-bye. Take care.
Hope that you have liked the video, and we will meet again in our next video release of the tutorial. And if you are new to this channel, please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to get the information of the next release of the tutorial. Please share it with your friends and others also. Thank you for the time being. Take care. Stay at home. Bye-bye. Take care.